A Nightmare on Elm Street from 2010 is often considered one of the worst horror remakes ever made. It wasn't just fans that had a problem with it, critics from back in 2010 also didn't like this movie. Even though it was a moderate box office success, it didn't get renewed for a sequel because generally people didn't enjoy the movie. Fast forward 12 years later, I actually believe that critics and the audience in general were wrong about A Nightmare on Elm Street 2010. So in this video today, I'm going to be telling you guys why I think they got it wrong and why A Nightmare on Elm Street 2010 is actually a great movie. Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of Beyond the Mask. In today's episode, we're taking a closer look at A Nightmare on Elm Street 2010, or more importantly, why this movie was better than critics and maybe even you considered at the time that you watched it. So without further ado, let's get into this video by taking a look at some key points that was often criticized that I think made the movie pretty good. So firstly, I want to talk about Freddy Krueger himself. I'm a huge fan of the original take on Freddy Krueger. I think that Robert Englund's performance was unmatched and he defined that role, and I believe that his performance was iconic enough to not need to be replaced. But I believe the actual take on Freddy in the 2010 movie was extremely dark and sinister, and despite people disagreeing with the backstory of him and arguing against why he did what he did, I want to point out that this was the Freddy that Wes Craven wanted to make back in 1984. It's just the studio wasn't confident enough of making this character so dark, and that's one of the reasons why we didn't really get much insight into Freddy's backstory. So this is where they wanted to go in the first place. This was always the plan for Freddy Krueger. I felt like we knew him more and got more insight into Freddy himself than we did in all of the installments in the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise with the original Freddy. So I felt the backstory was pretty good. But also, I also believe that his performance was underrated. I don't think it was a terrible performance. I thought that he delivered his lines pretty dark and sinister, and I felt that they took away that comedy element and just had a really dark and brutal Freddy, and that's something that I enjoyed personally. I preferred it to what Robert Englund's character had become, because some of the Nightmare on Elm Street sequels saw Freddy take a more comedic light, and that's something that I think they missed out on, and I think that this Freddy got it right. I want to talk about the cast next. Now, I believe personally this has been voiced quite a lot online by a few friends of mine when I posted about this last week, but I think that Katie Cassidy should have been the leading star of this movie. She was the one who sort of was the Drew Barrymore of this. Personally, I would have been on board if she'd have been Nancy. Katie Cassidy's performance in this was probably one of the best I've seen of her in a horror movie, and that's something that people also overlooked. I wasn't really a massive fan of Rooney O'Mara as Nancy. I just didn't really take to the character. I felt that the second half of the film, when she sort of stepped in, wasn't the best part of it. I thought that the start was better. And so when she sort of stepped in, I didn't really take to the character at all. Kyle Gallner as Quentin was really good. I enjoyed his performance too. I wasn't really convinced with Thomas Dekker. I thought he was a little bit miscast in his role, but that's just a personal preference of mine. I still didn't dislike the performance. It sort of felt like all the way through these characters were constantly being watched, even in the day. You knew they were battling something, and something that they couldn't actually stop. And I thought the story overall, with how they sort of had him connected to them, and the doubt of whether, you know, he was bad, or, you know, did they actually send him down for nothing, I thought that that was quite an interesting twist. It added a bit of layer to the characters, but also it added a bit of layer to the relationship between the victims and Freddy as well. We had a whole picture from preschool showing us exactly, you know, which characters were being targeted, and I thought that the aspect of having them all moved on, and some of them lived away and some of them were famous, but they were still being targeted, I thought that was so dark and very, very clever. The inclusion of micro naps was also something that was very much welcome, something that I believe the original movies really did overlook. I just really thought that they really touched on that very well. Moving on to visual effects, I thought the dream sequences in this movie were the best, and I mean that. I really thought they were the best in any of the Freddy movies. I thought the transition between the normal world into the dream world were so well done, and I thought that the whole visual effects of the kills was also brilliant. I didn't have any faults with any of the death scenes. You know, it's interesting to point out that the director of this movie was good at doing music videos, so it makes kind of sense that this would be a high point of the movie for me. Overall, my conclusion is this: I do have faults with this movie. It's not a perfect movie. I felt that some of the acting was a bit shoddy, pacing was a little bit off in places, and even though I have my views on the Freddy franchise, I've always been a fan of it, I don't believe this is the worst Freddy movie ever made. I wouldn't put it at the bottom of my list. I did actually quite like some of the performances, the darker Freddy and so on. I just think that this movie was overlooked, and I think that if people watch it again now without the attachment to the original, I think you would find you'd enjoy it a little bit more. You know, I don't think that it was a crazy plot. I don't think it's the worst remake ever made. I think it's one of probably my favorite horror remakes because of just how much they did sort of stay true to the plot but elevated it a little bit. And so in my opinion, I will always say this, that I believe that A Nightmare on Elm Street 2010 is underrated. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like the video. That lets me know that you're enjoying this content. If you're interested in more content like this, be sure to hit subscribe. And without further ado, I'm going to close this video off on a quote from A Nightmare on Elm Street 2010.
Wake up! You're bleeding.